Hi everyone, and welcome to the channel. This video is only going to be for patrons, so it'll delve a little bit more into the process, at least my process, of how I come up with these sketches. So first we're going to start with a base sketch. I know a lot of the speedruns that I've been doing have been no sketch, no idea, no clue whatsoever, just dive right in and start drawing. But you're probably going to get better results from working with a smaller composition. So what you can do is just come up with a rough sketch on one layer and then shrink that layer down to a thumbnail so that you have the overall composition to work with while you're working on the bigger picture and putting in more detail. So I'll show you what I mean by that now. So we're going to start with a smaller brush. 18 is fine, opacity of say 20-ish, and turn the flow to 100%. That gives us a nice semi-transparent rough line to work with. And so we're going to do a chimera, although I'd like to be able to, you know, do more than just a creature encyclopedia shot of it, so to speak, so not an anatomical shot or anything like that, but a an action shot of sorts. So probably going to work on not just the chimera, which would be coming up over here. And the shoulders. So that's the line of action. The line of action is used to describe in a single line the basic shape of the character or pose, action, whatever you want. Now, lines of action can be applicable to spaceships, to architecture, to anything like that. If you've got a baseline, you know, I might want mountains to go like that, and then I'll draw my mountains, you know, up that line. So it just basically gives me a rough idea in one line of how to describe my action. And I think this is talked about in really awesome books like Drawing on the Right Side of the Brain, which I haven't read in 2 decades, so I honestly can't even remember the name of the author right now. But it's a really good book. If you're looking at drawing in this type of style, where you really rough form everything and then put it together, Drawing on the Right Side of the Brain is one of the books that really helped get me started, along with my teacher, Nigel Lucas, who taught classical animation. He did some work for Mike Judge on Beavis and Butthead Do America, things like that. You know, he was a big proponent, I guess, of the line of action. If you can't describe it in one line, you know, maybe find a new line. So anyway, we've got our line. The other thing is the shoulders tend to counteract the hips. So, you know, if my shoulders are this line here, and say we've got, you know, a head here, and, you know, this is the waist, so the hips counteract. You know, if I'm reaching up here, you'll find that these, if I'm standing up, you'll see, like, if I'm reaching up, my shoulders, I don't know if you can see that, my shoulders go this way, but my hips, they go the opposite direction. It just has to do with our, you know, balance. So, and I'm going to have to dim this one down because there is going to be another, let's put another character in here, we'll call this one Lines. Knight. So we're going to put like a knight versus a chimera. So I am for our knight too. Let's have him down here. Yeah. this is how I draw, so it doesn't have to be how you draw. Again, if you find yourself too large on the page, you can always bring it down. I work at 4096 by 4096 pixels of resolution, so it's large format. It'll make them off to the side here a little bit. I want to be able to get some of the leg detail and stuff without putting his face directly into or over the crotch of the creature, if you will. Okay, so again, the shoulders, if they're going this way, your hips are kind of going to be going this way. And let's have them kind of touch this stuff up later, like as far as, you know, head pose. Like, I kind of want him looking up. That has it basically. I have to keep in mind where this chimera's head is, right? Sword's gonna be. That's pretty good, I guess. Here. Just going to shrink that down again. Chimera is obviously going to be quite a bit bigger than a human. I'm still not sure about placement for this guy yet, but or whether it's even going to be a guy. Maybe make it a warrior woman. Not sure about the feet placement quite yet, because I may decide to turn this leg around, and I don't want them on the same height for sure. I do not want them on the same level. One is going to be in front of the other. What's up, Tesla? You're obviously very distraught, kitten. So we're going to have the scabbard maybe coming back here, the sword. Maybe. Now, figure out just how big this armor is going to be. Don't have to work out all the details, but just some of what you're looking for. Shield? I mean, the shield's really going to cover up that other arm quite a bit. We can see how it's going to look. I almost feel like a shield is just going to be too cliche. Or maybe the shield should be... not up. I'm just wondering if the pose should be more dynamic. But that's fine. For now, this is going to do. actually drawing the inside of the shield right now, so I can gauge the curvature of the outside of the shield. All of this is rough, so it doesn't have to be. You know, you don't have to worry about ruining the drawing. So we got to remember blade position. Which way is that blade going to be facing? You know, you don't want your blade flat like he's holding it away. Now he's ready to do battle with this thing. So we're going to just reduce the lines on that now. Just to kind of get it out of the way, we still want to be able to vaguely see where it is. And we're going to go to lines, change this to lines chimera, save it. And, okay, so this chimera, I had previously done an iteration that was fairly abstract, but I've kind of discovered that abstract is something I'm not that great at. I'm working on it, but I'm really not that great at it yet, so I'm going to stick with some detail and have some fun versus, you know, get frustrated over me not knowing. So, knowing what to do, sorry. So to continue this line of action, you know, it's going to come right out of its butt, and there is a serpent on the end of this thing, on the end of this thing's tail. There, I like that line much better. I'm not sure I like that, but how long is this tail going to be? Well, let's give it a nice long tail here. So you just block that in. And last time I did a closed mouth snake. This time I think I'm going to try and do a open mouth. Yeah, I'm just going to kind of block that in. And maybe the tail is going to be too long. Maybe it's coming too far forward. I think it is, actually. So we probably, you know, this is where you can just get rid of that. Don't worry about it. We're going to try something else. What we should actually do is get the legs and the wings and other heavy items bulked in. But I would like to know where this tail's at. It should be natural. Yeah, you know, if your line feels too forced, it's probably not going to happen biologically for this creature. You know, unless you're dealing with a robot or something of that nature, but that kind of felt right there. I don't know if I wanted everything facing him, just simply because this, you know, the butt of this creature is going to be down here. And then we have these legs. A much more stable stance than the abstract that I've done. I don't know if I can pull, well, I can pull that up here. Just to give you, like, to quickly show you what I had done. So this is the abstraction that I'd worked on before. And I really liked this dragon. The goat was not too bad. The snake was okay, but the eyes is the only thing out of this whole abstraction, and a little bit of the teeth that I really liked, but it doesn't have, you see the stance, and I'm totally forgetting about the cloven hooves here too, So on the back, it's not necessarily going to be pause, which you could do like that. Actually, we'll leave that for now. It's really, or you can make it, cloven hooves pretty quick. And this thing is going to be like, raw, so really exaggerated pose. There's its midsection. Oh yeah, like that's a much more aggressive. See, now we can tell that tail is not going to work from that pose, right? Go back in here. And we can tell that the line that I actually did there is better tail-wise than the other thing. So, and actually, I'm going to work out the arms right now. And this arm, maybe he's got it back. Ready to strike. So you could have it as that. I don't know if that's too much of a... See, I don't know if I like that pose at all, to tell you the truth. I think I like it with the arm down a bit more. I think we'll definitely end up with the lion's head around there. Some ground going here, so I'm just gonna fake that in a little bit. Alright, let's figure this tail out here. So tail comes out the back. I actually like that line a lot better. Still just doesn't feel natural. Oops. Sometimes you gotta just like get real messy with it. Yeah, because the tail itself is should be a bit erratic. That's actually probably gonna work. That right there, I think, is the line that I've been looking for. What's going on there, kitten? Hey? So we can work out a little bit of a thicker tail. I don't know if it's gonna work for the snake though. The snake tail. Seeing as that too big. Well, I'm not sure if I am pleased with that. I think the snake's head's too big because it's going to be a little bit in the distance, so let's just keep it nice and small for now. So work in the shoulders. This thing's got a big upper body. Hips could come in like that. It's kind of rearing up. And don't worry about this person in front. Just draw the chimera body. And I think we're going to have the head of this dragon thing coming down. And like, I don't know, screaming at him. Ready to bite. So the line helps for this too. Because as you see, we got a bit messy. So this is where you'd want to figure out. Okay, so we have a goat head that has to come in here. We have a dragon head that has to come in here. Another set of shoulders that you can't really see on that side. You won't be able to see it because of the dragon head. And I don't know how short this dragon head's really supposed to be. Short. And the goat.
Tesla, what is it that you are doing? Stop meowing.
Seriously. Kitten, I'm recording stuff. To figure out whether or not this pose is going to work. I don't know if it's going to work. Okay, so it's hard to see what I'm doing right now. Maybe it's not. Maybe you can see that there's, you know, sort of a lion head in there. So I'm trying to work out exactly where the heads are going to be placed, since they are such a focal point of this particular creature. The size of this line a little bit. Curve it out a little more. Which will take care of that whole awkwardness, and maybe have this thing a little more pointed in the nose. We're gonna have some drool, of course. I just don't know if the dragon's head is going to be able to come around like that. So we're just going to erase that. Easy enough. And take that out too. be, or where I'll be satisfied with it now. The next of this thing is somewhat in question. Like, how the hell does this thing have a dragon's head? A goat's head. So I think what we'll do is we'll work in the arms first. Too close for the goat. The goat horns, rough those in. Figure out basically where you want the nose and the eyes. It is still a bit of a barrel-chested critter. And it's got wings, so got those to throw in addition to the goat's head, the lion's head, the goat's body, well, the giant goat's body, and the snake for a tail, the dragon head. This creature's insane. That's kind of good. I think I'm reasonably happy with the positioning of the heads on this one. Okay, so I am, in fact, okay with this composition. I am going to move that goat's head. And so that we can... Yeah. Just get the head placements right. So you can take that. I'm going to paste it back there. We're going to move it around. Yeah. Move it up a bit. Move it over here. Maybe move our knight. You know, more to the... Just off center. Try to avoid putting him in the center. I'm not even sure that I like that. There's parts of this thing that I like. Let's just fill in the wings and see where it goes. So wings, trying to figure out exactly how I want those. Line. It's confusing the wing situation altogether. And the back would actually. Bring this up, join it with this. This is getting a little bit messy right now. Let's lower the opacity on that. And we're going to just eliminate some of the lines here so we can see what the heck we have going on. Okay, so we have the lion's head in the center. Dragon's head over here. We have our goat's head over here. And somewhere in the mess of this, you're supposed to be. Ears and horns and a neck and a back and wings. Okay, so switching off to the brush, we're going to finish up where these wings come out. We're going to make these wings a little bit more bat-like. It's a little skinnier, a little bonier. It's okay to put detail in this time. You're going to end up making a few, well, if you're doing it like I do, you're going to end up making a few different iterations of the drawing. So, you know, get as detailed as you want. You're just going to dim it down, add more detail. Dim it down, add more detail until you're satisfied with the level of detail that you've added. Are the ears visible on a lion? Do you normally see the ears? Maybe not. Maybe it's just mane. Feels like it would kind of just be lion's mane. Yeah, so let's take the opacity up. I kind of want to be able to define this lion's mane a little bit better. There's a lot of hair and stuff going on. A lion's mane is kind of like just a big old man's beard. I guess the goat would have a bit of hair off the chin, too. That's what I was missing off my abstract drawing. And these goat horns are actually... Yeah, they should curve like that. The other one out. Sure that we have enough neck. So, you know, if this happens where you're like, oh man, I like that head, but I don't like where it's at, take it out and move it into what you feel is a better position. Maybe increase the size so it more matches the body proportion. Give it a little bit of neck, right? It's gonna need some neck in there. Yeah, 58%. So now I'd increase that so that you make it equivalent. Merge these two layers. And then dim it down again. And now you can continue to work by putting a neck. I really gotta change this back down though. We're just trying to work out the rough. That could be something like that. I like that better. I like that the wing parts would kind of come up on the back. I mean, it's kind of got a complicated body. And then, of course, the pose that I selected was a bit more dynamic. I'm not so happy with this dragon head on the right. So we're gonna take that out and see if we can't do something better with it. Valley of the Chimera. Why not? So if you're watching this, you are a patron, and I thank you very much for helping. this. What is the time? 9:30. Maybe I should have a pod down. Feels like the paw should be up, like it's gonna be over here. See where the tail comes through here. But this shoulder would actually be coming from back here. So we're okay on that. I'm not so sure it wouldn't be down here. Seems like how it would be. And we can still see where that tail is coming through here. So you can quickly fill that back in. That's a shame because I really did like how that back leg was posed. So you aren't probably going to see that there, the leg behind the guy. Sleep. I don't know why I keep putting this thing with more of a python head on the end of the tail. I guess I'm trying not to duplicate the dragon. tail is going to go behind these legs here. I don't know where that line was even coming from. I think that was from our previous... previous sketch. So it's Saturday here. Sure what day it is you're watching this, but hope you're having a creative day. So we can definitely start working out a bit more detail now. Even the line knight, or the knight, bring him up. See, we have a pretty decent composition so far. Just did that. That's one problem I definitely do have, is like not paying attention to what layer that I'm on. So lines, chimera, and save. Yeah, now that I've got that. So, oh, that's what that was. The wings. So the wings are going to come down back here. Distinction on the horns. I honestly don't know if that's what I'm going to do yet. We'll put a pin in that. So the line underneath that leads to the legs really isn't working like that. It is there. I feel that it is more so there. So I feel like we've kind of changed the pose too much there. So what we are going to do is take these parts of the chimera. What the hell is your problem, Lasso? And we're going to maneuver to something a little bit more conducive to that body pose. Like, oh no, it's all gone. Don't worry about it. You're just making a slight modification. See, now that fits better with the body pose. And you'll be able to see a little bit more wing in there as well. Save it. We're going to get rid of this knight now that we know where the chimera is supposed to be relative to the knight. And now I can see what I'm doing a little bit better. What I might even do is take these lines, duplicate it, just so I get a more even balance of light and dark on the sketch. Merge that and then reduce it. See, now we've got a pretty much a more even toned sketch. And I can start, you know, filling in parts of the sketch that maybe you took out previous. Kitten. This leg's the one that isn't working, actually. So we're going to take that right on out of there. And we're going to take this part out of here. And we can kind of see now where that wasn't working. Like, this is the body now. That other leg would actually be quite a bit back here. Which again won't matter much because that's going to be there. Sitting. So we'll have to figure that out. A little bit more spiky on the wingtips. Got some battle scars. You don't want those wings to interfere with that dragon head too much. We're here, grab all of this and shrink it down. More of those wings in. And you don't really have to worry, because if I were to zoom this in, it's huge. This drawing is huge. don't need to worry about, you know, oh, I'm going to lose all that detail. Let's see here. The wings. Of what's going on here. And actually that wing would probably come out more like that. That would end here. And that'd be my phone ringing. Duty calls. This artwork stuff isn't my only job. So, oh boy. A get assist request. Let me tell you what a waste of money that was. So remember what I was saying before about a thumbnail. Well, you could take this now and you could transform it and you can put it down there, and then you can use that as the basic composition to just start drawing and composing the actual thing. So a lot of people do that. I am not going to do that this time. Most of my lines tend to be good enough roughed in to skip the whole thumbnail, but if you want to just, you know, do the roughest of rough and block in your thumbnail, work with that and then build on a bigger drawing from there, sure, absolutely do that. Everybody's got a different method. Oops, and again, wrong layer. Gotta watch that. Save this, and that's a pretty good base for now, so I'm just going to stop and take a break, and then I will be back in a bit. Okay, and I think we're actually going to take this dragon's head. Going to take this head out, paste it back in, and bring it down in size a little bit. That's more appropriate. So it's somewhat on par with the goat, and even though it does have a longer neck, maybe it doesn't even have a longer neck. Maybe it's just got a shorter neck. So 22, we're going to bring that up to 100. We're going to merge these two. Back down to where it was before. And now we can start working out going to work on some finer lines. Reduce the Chimera lines a bit more. Just gonna start working in some finer details. Just a super fine line if you just want to, you know, break out some more detail and then eventually dim this one down and put in another thing of detail. also important not to take this stuff too seriously. We could draw frickin' laser beams coming out of this thing's head. Wouldn't matter. You can always erase, you can always undo, you can always draw something else. So I don't like that bottom jaw. This way, just by changing a couple of the lines. Maybe we should reduce the snout, so you can do that too, right? Easy enough. Right. That's rows of teeth. there's tufts on the end of a goat's ears. It's kind of weirding me out now. It's almost like the goat with ears does not work. Maybe it's just those ears, the positioning of them. It's going to have fur running down a portion of its belly because of the lion mane coming down. Does the Chimera have, like, dragon back legs? Like, I'm trying to remember. Maybe it does. I'm not certain. What the classic Greek mythology version of it is. So we'll have to figure out these back legs a little bit here. fire side of things, and the dragon's on the blacker side of things, and then the lion's the regular lion brown colors. If I wasn't painting this in the end, I probably would describe that with a bit more shading like I'm doing here. But that's not my intent. A little bit of fur around the edge. I guess that's not too bad, except for it really interferes with the goat head, which we kind of want to keep separate. So we're just moving the wing over a little bit. Into it later. For now, I just want to get the proportions a little bit more proper. Here's the wings in the background there. Those twists in the bone were not working, so we're just straighten that out by clearing out those lines. Tail coming up back here, getting kind of lost behind the wing. We can actually show it through a little bit of the wing in the final painting. Probably had it pretty close there with that last line. It's just too broad. That's a little more like it. Thank you. chimera-ish, right? Monotone shit ever. Like, oh, don't say shit. You know what? I can say whatever I want. It's my channel. And there was clearly an adult warning on this thing. Thank you. the tail would actually come around here. No, because we've kind of changed the, I guess we didn't change the body position a little bit. And then let's have it come around in this direction instead. Skip the tongue on that snake because we're already doing that with the dragon. And I guess this is Chimera lines too. And we're gonna save it. And the lines on the knight, we're gonna create a new one. And we're gonna start breaking out knight lines. Save it. Check. Check. So now I'm going to go over these lines a little bit more. Excuse me. feel like a cloak is missing almost, but no, I just hate adding a cloak because it's a bit of a cheat. It's like, oh, suddenly you don't have to define body parts because you just draw a big wavy cloak and now you can cover up all the legs and everything else. These legs are definitely going to have to get longer. About right. See now if I undo that, see how it just doesn't look right. There we go. Looks a bit better anyhow, and I think we just need to take the whole thing and shrink it down even further. This is a frightening beast. This thing is large and in charge. Funny. Just change it. Somebody messaging me. And this is life carrying on in normal fashion. Interesting. It's a BC number. Interesting. That is not working. This guy's in a bit of shit here. Right? I should say, a little bit of shit. Now, if we want, we can dim down more of the Chimera. I don't know why I put that line in. I'm not even on the right layer. So we're gonna save it, because I'm fairly happy with this so far, except for these come in sleeves now, so this would be chain as well. Now that's how they were, right? They had some sleeves. This guy gonna get bit by the dragon head. Actually, I think I'm safe to join these two layers, and then I'm going to actually take him. And that should be okay, actually. We're gonna see, make this guy disappear. Wasn't sure whether I wanted a longer blade. And actually, I'm going to take this blade down a bit here. That's good. Felt like a little bit of detail was necessary to define this guy's form a little bit more. So, Chimera, let's take away those lines and see what we got there. I do like it with a little bit of the messiness in there. So that's what I'm going to do, is join these lines. Down, we could put more into it. hard part about doing stuff just right out of your head, like, is I have no point of reference. I kind of have this vision of what it looks like. But, you know, sometimes it's easy to stall on the details. Still rough, but I don't want to do it so it looks like shit. There, always nice to take it from a different angle, I think. Maybe he's got, you know, some kind of dragon or phoenix or something on his shield. Chimera. Because, I mean, overall, we're satisfied with the composition. Chimera lines 3. We're going to have to darken it up, or we're going to have to lighten up this Chimera. Tesla. Now we're working on a finer level of detail. Well, I suppose it would help. Sorry. Not that you really needed to see me to see what was going on anyway. I'll turn this up just a little bit. Thank you. as I look over then to check and see if my if I'm on the right layer. That is not the. That's a terrible time to have. To be checking on that. After so much work done. Draw all of this stuff in at a fairly consistent darkness. Although for wings that are in behind at the end, I'm going to lighten up the wings, and then I'll lighten up the ass end of this thing, because as you know, as things are lightening as they're moving further away from your field of vision, right? Some of these lines in the rough sketch I like, and some I do not. So I'm going to keep the ones that I like and get rid of the ones that I don't. Again, this is all original. This is not, you know, I didn't start with a sketch. I didn't look at a bunch of Chimera before I started this. So a lot of it's coming from my my vivid image of something from a monster manual, Dungeons and Dragons book from decades ago, and my knowledge of Greek mythology, which, you know, is probably pretty spotty by now. I know I was really into it when I was a kid, but you know, how much do I really remember these days? Probably more than I think, maybe. And maybe not as much as I'd like. Rush. Okay. I also have not much of a clue about what a goat's face looks like. I'm desperately trying to remember. Nostrils go up like that. This is probably where I should look at a reference photo. Just to make sure my... maybe I shouldn't. Like, it's a chimera. It's a fantasy creature. Who cares, right? You know, you draw your chimera however you draw your chimera. Nobody's telling you your chimera can't have, you know, giant googly eye right in the middle of its forehead. We're gonna do some wrinkles here, but this isn't a... this isn't a googly-eyed chimera. Not sure how I'm going to play that one out quite yet, so guess it is still continuing the theme of the original, like the abstract drawing that I did. Thinking of putting something over here for this chimera to be defending, like maybe he's, you know, there's an idol or a statue buried, half buried in the sand over here, and this guy's here to take it, and the chimera is like, fuck you, man, you ain't taking my statue. On these hooves in the back. Actually looked a bit better. coffee time. That's what time it is. Coffee time. Sing it with me. All right. Moving the F on. That I'm still working. What the hell is going on right now? This thing's shitting the bed. Better save it. Oh. Somehow, I got an off of black. Curved it the wrong way, buddy. Let's try and keep a theme going. This chimera is coming along beautifully. There we go. thin, but not too thin. Look at this wise old goat. Wise old goat. Okay, let's do a little bit of this. Time to put the horn in the goat. And I like the original line, so I'm going to try and replicate that best I can. Doesn't have to be perfectly smooth, it's not going to be anyhow. There's going to be striations along the horn. And I'm actually going to just put a few in place so I can be sure that as I'm drawing them from one end to the other that they don't get all screwed up. Pretty happy with how the composition is going. You know, it's funny, you'll probably see me making some mouth moves too, and inside my head I'm like thinking about like what's happening at tonight's D&D game. I'm not even here, like I'm not even with this drawing right now. It's so messed up. I don't even know how my brain does that. I'm like not even thinking about it. It's just like automatic. Okay, and I really screwed up this goat's horns before. That's actually a little bit more accurate, I think, given the way they'd be going a little bit further off in this direction. So I'm going to keep that particular line. Again, with the horn, you'll want to know where those striations are going to occur. You can put a line, you know, right down the middle like that, and then use that as your guide. But I kind of already have an idea of where that line is. You can kind of see the one underneath it. It's almost correct. So these horns don't look at all proper. I think a big part of it is that I've got this goat's head in kind of an odd position. Like, it's okay, it works for the composition, but it's not conducive to getting this horn correct. That seems right. That does seem right. Maybe just curve it out a bit further. I think I can live with that. And this isn't the last detail drawing. This is, I might take it a step further on the detail. Actually, this particular style of drawing, it's actually kind of reminding me of Ernie Chan. Not that I am in any way as good as Ernie Chan. Ernie Chan is just amazing. If you haven't seen Ernie's work, I recommend reading as many Savage Sword of Conan books as you possibly can. Not just for Ernie Chan's art, but the stories are awesome. And I think now looking at, like, if I were to say I have a style, I can definitely say that Ernie Chan is an influence. That looks dumb. So we're just gonna take that right out of there. I like what I had on this other side. That is also the line I was looking for. Sides of the wing. I don't even know that you'll know that that's part of the wing. So this is where the wing kind of joins up with the bone. Detailed there. And this is the tail coming up here. And that is going to go here and around here. Belly, I mean. It's also really weird me narrating this process. Like, if you're seeing this, you're one of my patrons, so, you know, I feel completely confident, you know, telling you that this is, it's daunting, you know, being able to talk to you and being able to share parts of my process. Usually I just, you know, and I think you can tell from a lot of my drawing that I'm just like, zombied right in. really focused and intent on what I'm drawing. But you know, the narrating, I guess it's helping me to understand what it is that I'm thinking during parts of these process, and maybe modify some parts of my thought of my thought patterns to accommodate different styles or new techniques, or at the very least getting better at the techniques that I do have. I was looking for that more rounded look, and I kind of wanted the dragon head snaking up and then joining up with the body. Details here. Maybe I don't want to put all that in there. And sometimes you want to just have it a little more open. It feels more organic. Even that is just getting to be too much in that area. So that's a little bit better. Man, manes are hard to draw. I mean, they're easy. They're a bunch of lines, but you know, making them feel natural, that's the kicker. See, and I didn't like that last couple of lines there. I wanted a more rounded, more organic, more open. Oof, that's a serious fang going there. Actually like that. I like it a lot. Dental pattern going here. And we gotta put the teeth in the background. One tooth is too dark. I mean, even if you were, you know, gonna have a blacked out tooth or something like that, I don't think it would be that dark. Foreground teeth are a bit more prominent than the background teeth.
Well, hello, Tesla. Welcome to the party.
You'll see her pass by. You probably already did. She's up in the window now. She's like the mascot of these sessions. So saith I. See advantage to running your own channel? You can dictate that your cat is a part of the crew. Nothing I liked about that. I do like the idea of these. Frills, though. Where the spines on the head start splitting, and there's two sets. So it goes up like this and then spreads across into two different sets. So we've got these ones in the background. I'll have to lighten them up in the final painting. Ooh, did I just let it slip? Am I going to paint this one? I honestly don't know. In truth, I would love to have somebody else paint them. Somebody more competent at digital painting than I am. But that is not the name of this channel. This channel is not Get Somebody Else to Digitally Paint Something For You channel. This is Creator Crucible, where we attempt to create. So, that said, you can be guaranteed that if this gets digitally painted at all, it'll be done here. And we'll figure it out. Neck looks like. I'm assuming there's gonna be some fur. Maybe not like woolly, not like a sheep. Are they like sheep? Gonna have to do some goat studies, I guess. Figure. Yeah, after I completely smash this thing. The lion's actually turning out a lot better than I had expected, simply because I don't really know. I know what a lion looks like, and just trying to conjure a lot of that stuff out of memory really sucks too. We don't want to draw every hair. Obviously, we want to. Oh, is that on lines two? Oh, it is. So we're just going to erase in and around these so we can kind of see better what the heck is going on. And now we can see more that it's kind of curving around, I think. What do you think? Trying to figure this mane out. And it's so bushy. And I'm losing, because the lines are a little bit lighter, or a little bit darker, and a little bit darker, and a little bit lighter, I'm starting to lose the flow of the main. And in truth, what I should do to figure it out is start a whole new layer, create some darker lines, and just, you know, work it out. You know, you want the main to be like that. That's great. That's actually looking more like a lion's mane, right? I think. You know, you want to figure out where those ears are. Alright, so you have an idea. There's where the hair is going to be. That makes sense. Alright, then you could actually drop that in behind here, tone it down or up as you needed. And now, if you liked that, you know, work in those details. You know, get rid of some of the lines under here that might be creating problems. So that you can see, oh, there's the shape of the beard. Same thing with line 3 here. You know, let's get rid of some of this stuff so we can see the shape of the beard. The mane. Mane, beard. It's a lion beard. That's what it is. And then what I'll probably do is, you know, because we don't like those lines. Well, you can almost see it just in the outline. But because I don't like those lines, the other ones, I'm just going to do a quick trace here. Just a couple of quick lines. You know, if you want to put that ear back in there. I'm sure if I'm going to show the ears. I guess it makes sense doing them now. And now I can eliminate those lines. And see, I still have a pretty good idea of where that mane is going to be. Cool? Cool. There we go. Now you can get rid of that layer. You've used it to shape the beard. All right, we're going to get rid of this, because that's really kind of screwing the whole thing up. And there we go. That's looking a lot better. I can turn, how the opacity is at 24 on this, so it's already where we need it to be. Actually, I think I had it up to 37. Yeah, positive I did. Honestly, sometimes I surprise myself at how often I can hit the mark and redraw the same line, no problem. And then other times, just like 20, 30 times trying to capture that same line I did in the rough drawing and reproduce it in the fine line. I mean, because truly the idea behind the fine line is that that's the last line. You're not going to sketch it and make it all weird. You're fine lining it. You just want one pass. Well, just one line. So you don't want it to look sketchy like I'm doing right now. You know, unless sketchy is what you're looking for in the end product. That might be the style of drawing or painting or artwork you're trying to... See, this is where I really need a reference for a lion's beard. Like, what have I got going on for colors and stuff? What about whiskers? Do I put whiskers on this line? Probably not. I don't think whiskers are going to impress anyone. It's not a... I mean, that's a big cat. I wonder how big lion whiskers actually are. I can't conceive of them for the life of me, but... I don't think I'm going to put... I don't want to put whiskers. Like, if I were to put one... Just a couple. Yeah, he just looks like a big pussycat at that point, so we're gonna leave those out of there. We're gonna have to be careful with the lion's mane a little bit, just to not give him a bad haircut. Those ones we are going to fade out a little. Normally I'd do it after the fact, but here we need to know right away that that's background is what's going on there. Is that kitten? Probably is kitten getting into something upstairs. Me, like a responsible parent, running to check it out. That was sarcasm, by the way. Okay, so remember what I was saying about getting that line? That's pretty close, but it touched that other line. Yeah, actually, I'm okay with that one. The other, I guess this is technically a fingernail. Technically, lots of bat in these wings. Sizable tear in the wing here. to reproduce. There we go. I thought it was going to be another one of those. Oh no, I can't do it. Well, we don't believe in can't here, sir. Or ma'am. Although, I'll tell you one thing, I cannot live with that line. If you're wondering what I'm doing on the other hand here, I've got my Control-Z, Control-Z, however you want to pronounce that. We've got the undo ready with the left hand. Just in case I screw something up, which as you've seen is more than just a possibility, it is a likelihood. That's okay. It's all in the name of having fun and drawing something, right? Living life. You make mistakes, no problem. You just step up to the plate and fix those things. Try to fix those things. Maybe we're going to have a bit of drool on the other side of this mouth as well. It's probably going to be mostly dark in here. And now we're going to actually add a few. Scaly elements to the dragon. Try to keep them from being warty. Man, that was a lot of like screw-ups on that line. Just trying to get this fine needle point on the end of it. And these I'd probably start fading off, but I'll fade them afterwards. Yeah, that feels a bit more natural. It's supposed to be fleshy, webbing between what are technically fingers. So it's got to have flex, it's got to have some, fleshy qualities to it. So 1, 2, 3, 4 fingers, thumb 5. Doesn't have to be, could be 20, could be 4. In this case, I'm really putting the bat into these. What time are we at? Honestly, not sure how long I've been zenning out on this thing, but we'll find out when it's all said and done. I do like that line. I'm going to continue that trail of those last few lines were mistakes. But we're going to trail that down onto the stomach. That line was a mistake. There we go. Can I talk about Game of Thrones on here? Probably not. Somebody watching it might not have seen this series. It's a great series. It is. So there's lots of people with mixed feelings about the end, but that I think happens with any show. So we're just gonna lightly put those in the background so that we know there's wings back there, but they're not in our face. These two. Or this wing on the, so it'd be the left wing, is gonna have to be lighter. And we'll lighten it as we go into the final pass of detail. We can actually, just for shits and giggles, we're going to just pop a line in here, and we're going to do background lines too. And we're going to save that, because we made some pretty decent progress. Cat paws as they are like needles. And I don't think anybody's trimming this bad boy's claws to keep them down to a reasonable size, so we're just gonna make the assumption that those bad boys are like needles. Fairly loose and abstract back here. And we're actually going to bump that back up there. I didn't like how far down that was carrying. Interfered with what the shield had going on. I think here too, just keep it fairly abstract. Maybe not that long line. was not doing it for me. See, this is the advantage, right, of like doing it in different layers. It's like, if you want to delete that line, you can delete that line. What is going on with that background? So, B, and let's change that to white. Oh, it's because I've got the opacity set down. Okay, so that is not going to work. Let's just grab this and fill it. Where are those lines? Oh, they're part of the night. So I could actually, or rather I'm going to have to, draw carefully. This is my own kind of screw up. So I didn't erase these lines earlier, should have. But now they're gone. Awesome sauce. Alright, back to putting some detail into the background here. I was like, that's not happening. You know, some things you're like, yeah, fuck it. Let's just put, you know, a stone here, some grass there. We're gonna indent the ground a little bit here because we want to show that this creature's putting some weight into the ground. Those abstract. It's like, oh, come back from that a bit. Some things you just gotta leave the hell alone. Like, just leave them alone. They're done. You know, we are going to put a little bit of a layer of webbing between what would be the index finger and the thumb. You know, right there. Same thing over here. Just enough to show that it's there. Well, this is just awesome. I really like like it when a drawing turns out better than you hope. Sometimes you get into a piece of artwork and then you hit a wall, or a big problem is not finishing it, coming back to it too late when your mind isn't in whatever phase of thought that it was in when you started that drawing originally. This guy is in some trouble. He better have a plus 10 Vorpal weapon and be about level 12, or he is in some serious, level 6-ish, or he's in some serious trouble. I'd say either way, he's in some serious trouble. Getting pretty close to time. Oh, I don't know why I put that line there. Actually, does it work? For some reason it won't let me undo that. I don't think it worked anyway. Going to work for me. We just got to add grass in a few places to make it look grassy. Some long plants, put a long plant, put a flower, Bob Ross it up, turn any line into something else. You want a little cave down here, perhaps like a mouse hole. Well, you just put a mouse hole down here. What's lurking in there. We're just gonna make that a happy little cave now. Right. Maybe a bigger rock over here, because big rocks happen too. this guy would be on some, you know, similar terrain. This is where you could put like some foreground blurred out elements, slightly, you know, really dark, and those would be your super foreground elements, and then your vision will be carried into the picture, and then as it gets lighter away, you'll lose the picture. Does that make sense? Oh, okay, so yeah, here's something that I just did. And I've done it a couple times, I can see right now. I've kept it most of them, which is good. But I can see I've filled in some lines on the... But that's okay. In the end, you know, there are, it's not really going to matter. I am still going to probably merge all of these and do one final pass. Maybe. And I was just about to do it again. Not even just about, I did it again. Like, gotta watch out for that stuff. You'll hook yourself. You'll get neck deep in a drawing and be like, oh, I need that layer separated. On the Chimera, yeah, I get rid of those as well. Clean up a lot of that background. I guess I'm okay with those lines. Should I go now? Probably. Okay, well, I'm probably gonna have to pick this up in another session. So that's what we'll do.